CPU, NET, and RAM. Resources on EOSIO. This is Sally. She's created an application that she wants to deploy on EOS, one of the blockchains built with the EOSIO protocol. What does she need to get it running? On other blockchains, Sally might deploy her app by paying a one-time mining fee. Then, when her users interact with the app, they would have to pay a mining fee as well, for every single transaction. Those fees add up fast, and they're collected by the miners, not by Sally. EOS and other EOSIO blockchains approach things differently. On EOSIO blockchains, developers like Sally don't have to pay to upload or update applications, and users don't have to pay to use them. Instead, both users and developers leverage EOSIO's three network resources to cover the network's costs. CPU is processing power. It's measured in microseconds. If Sally's app has a lot of complex transactions, she'll need more CPU. NET is network bandwidth. It's measured in bytes. If Sally's app handles a large number of transactions, she'll need more NET. CPU and NET are obtained by staking EOS tokens, or whatever token is designated for staking on other EOSIO chains. Staking is the process of locking up crypto for a period of time. EOSIO rewards people who stake their tokens by giving them access to network resources. There is no cost to stake apart from owning the token itself. And the more tokens Sally stakes, the more resources she gets. On EOS, regular users might only need to stake a fraction of one EOS to get all the CPU and NET they need. Users who need more bandwidth and resources, like gamers who make lots of transactions, might stake several EOS. And a developer like Sally might need to stake hundreds of EOS to cover all the processing power and network bandwidth her app needs. If she ever needs more, she can stake more EOS to get it. Or she can unstake her EOS if her resource needs decline. The third EOSIO resource is RAM. RAM is measured in kilobytes and represents data storage. The more on-chain storage developers like Sally need, the more RAM they need to acquire. Unlike CPU and NET, RAM is not obtained by staking. Instead, it's purchased through a market managed by EOSIO's core system software. If you're a new EOS user, you'll get all the CPU, NET, and RAM you need when you set up a new wallet. In the next lesson, we'll explore how apps are developed for EOS and other EOSIO blockchains.